Right, the car's ready. Let's get it out there. That's 11 laps of fuel remaining. Let's have you in at the end of this lap, please. position, front of the pack. And we're in front of Mayer, Leclerc and Ocon. The fastest lap at this point in time is a 1:20.1. We don't have the data for that, I'm afraid. Okay, Cali behind. Had to spend time repairing the damage to the car. Everyone ready? Okay, let's go. this lap then, coming to the pits at the end of this lap. Okay, we've got 10 laps of fuel to go, 10 laps of fuel left. Clear the garage, please. Cars ready to leave. and that's 11 laps of fuel remaining. Confirmed, we'll receive you at the end of this lap.
Finished, it's time to remind ourselves once again of our top three: Oscar Piastri, Russell, and Surfergo. Goodbye for now then, but really we're just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow. No more testing, no more practice. This is the real deal, and it's make or break here at round one of this year's Formula One World Championship. We're a stone's throw from the enormous Port Phillip Bay for today's race at the 3.28-mile Albert Park circuit. It's a bumpy racing surface here, and the 14 corners can prove especially difficult in the wet conditions. So watch out for a safety car at some point during this Grand Prix. It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Oscar Piastri lines up on pole position, and starting next to them is George Russell. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Surfer Girl, Mayer, Leclerc, Verstappen, Ocon, Joe, Bottas, De Vries, Hamilton, Sainz, Norris, Albon, Tsunoda, Sargent, Perez, Gasly, Hülkenberg, Stroll, Liam Lawson, and Kevin Magnussen fills the last spot on the grid. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today? The rain is falling today as battle commences for the World Championship once again. They've done very little running in these conditions, of course. Natalie Pinkham, this could make a mess of our expectations coming into this Grand Prix.
That's very true. If you want to mix up a motor race, a little bit of water on the circuit will do the trick nicely. The key to success today will be ensuring you're on the right tyre at the right time and making sure you can get them up to temperature.
Right then, the formation lap has started. And I must say, the weather conditions aren't the best today for visibility and for grip. As each driver performs this lap, they'll be wanting to settle in and concentrate, as this race, in these conditions, will require a lot of focus. So as all the cars take their positions on the grid, the teams will be hoping their strategies pay off for them in today's race. The question I'm asking is which teams have got it right, which ones have got it horribly wrong?
Off a bit, but the track is still going to be wet for a while. Be careful. Inters look like the best tyre for now. Make use of the overtake button and see what you can do. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. Green flag. Okay, red flag, mate. Red flag. No overtaking, please. We'll see you in the pit lane. Okay, there's been an incident on track resulting in loose debris. Fortunately, the marshals have managed... It's right, we can get a nice advantage here. Let's have a think about how we handle the rest of this race. Back out there. Again. Information on Perez. They're retiring from the race. Okay, you're doing well out there. Keep it up. We're looking at about 10 more minutes of rain. 10 minutes. Right, drop your speed. Our delta's too low and we're going to risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Okay, I think we're still on the right tyres for the time being. Okay, Russell's behind you now. Okay, car behind trailing us. 1.4 seconds. They're on a fresh set of inters. Their tyres are just one lap old. Your last lap time was a 1 minute 48.3. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until we get the green flags. VSC ending. Wait for the greens. Green flag. Russell behind. Okay, the gap is less than a second. They're on a fresh set of inters. Their tyres are just one lap old, and the time last lap was a 1:48.3. Catching the car ahead, well done, but be aware these tyres need to get us to the end of this race. And we're still happy that we're on the right tyres at the moment. We anticipate an end to this rain in around 5 minutes. Inters seem to be the fastest tyre for now. Okay, some information on Piastri. They seem to have an issue. Don't currently have the data for that request. Copy that, hards next time we box. battery charge is high, let's use that overtake button a bit more. Okay, and that's a red flag. Red flag. Keep the delta positive, and let's have you straight to the pit lane, please. There's been an incident on track, but officials aren't looking to push for a safety car. Done all right so far, but this is a chance to take a breath. We've got another half of this race to go, and there's still a big opportunity there. Good to get back on track. Let's make the best of this restart. Let's go. Conditions look stable at the moment. No rain currently expected. Inters look like the best tyre for now. Affirmative, medium tyres at the next stop. The tyre situation's an interesting one, but I think the right call is to stick with what we've got for now. Okay, we've got 31 laps of fuel remaining. don't think the line is really dry enough yet to start thinking about slicks. Let's hold on to the inters for a little while longer. DRS has been enabled. DRS is now enabled. Callie's coming in for a stop. Okay, we can't take you right now. Pit next lap, next lap. Hamilton's behind you now. Okay, gap to the car behind. Car behind, 2.0 seconds. They're on a fresh set of inters. Their tyres are 3 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. Time last lap was a 1 minute 31.1. Okay, it could be a risk with the circuit this greasy, but we think the slick might now be the quicker tyre. If you think you can keep it on the road, let's consider swapping over. Perfect job on the turn in there, mate. Looks like a nice stop time. We're happy with that one. Callie's ahead of you. Callie ahead. Okay, they're on fresh hards. Their tyres are just 1 lap old. Your last lap time was a 1:34.0. Thank you. use your overtake button more. It's time to utilise some of this energy. Come on. Ocon's behind you. Less than a second separates you. Okay, they're on fresh hards. Their tyres are 2 laps old. So the time last lap was a 1 minute 28.6. To the car in front is 4.0 seconds. Fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Well done. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 5.1 seconds. Flag. Okay, clear. Ahead is 8.2 seconds. If you think you can get past, make use of the overtake button and see what you can do. Try to stay with them. They might make a mistake and we could still regain the position. To your teammate ahead is 10.1 seconds. They're in second. Time last lap was a 1:23.2. It's Verstappen ahead. Okay, here's the gap that we're trailing the car ahead by. 1.1 seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 8 laps old. Your last lap time was a 1 minute 23.3. You're losing around 1.6 seconds. Okay, so the gap is 4.2 seconds. They're on old mediums. And the time last lap was a 1:23.0. Okay, good work. Great pass. Teammate ahead is 12.3 seconds. Tyre condition still looking good. Teammate ahead is 12.3 seconds. Okay, they're on old hard tyres. They're in second. Time last lap was a 1 minute 22.9. Wow, that was a heck of an impact. Let me know you're okay.
Some great battles on the streets of Melbourne today then, and they've taken a fantastic win. So Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
I want to know if that was as easy as it looked. An absolute masterclass today.
Well, what a thrilling end to an incredible Grand Prix weekend. Our top three finishers should be incredibly happy with what they were able to achieve out there today. Have a quick look at how the driver's standings have changed. After today's result, Callie Mayer is the new leader of the Drivers' Championship. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day? It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes moved to the top of the table. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out. Be sure to join us once again as we continue to bring you all the excitement of Formula One.